all are fit and fine and doing your study on regular basis. In previous lecture, we discussed about the physical features of India, about the Himalayas and the Northern Plains. Out of 6 physical features, we discussed 2. Now, remaining 4 we are going to cover in today's lecture, that is the Peninsular Plateau, the Coastal Plains, the Islands and the Deserts. So before going to start the next topic, that is the Peninsular Plateau, let us discuss the plate tectonic theory once again to understand the rise or the evolution of Himalayas and the plateaus. That the earth has a big landmass called as Pangaea, which is surrounded by huge water area called as Penthalsa. Now, what happened due to the tectonic plate theory or the disturbance, long time disturbance of the tectonic plates, this big continent divided into 2 small continents. One is Angara land, another is Gondwana land. Presently, India, South Africa, Australia, and Antarctica are the parts of Gondwana land. Again, after the division of these 2, Gondwana land and Angara land, in between the space raised and created a sea, huge mass of water, that is Tethys Sea. Now again, what happened due to the gradual drifting of the plate tectonic, again the land mass evolved. This land mass is called as Young Mountains. Presently called as Himalayas. So in this way we saw how the rise of Himalaya took place after Tethys Sea. It means there was Tethys Sea before Himalaya if we talk about the theory of tectonic plate. Now what happened? This Gondwana land, the second piece of mass land, where this drifted towards the north direction and created the Deccan Plateau or the Peninsular Plateau. Some part of this Gondwana drifted towards the northern part, and which we see in our country, that are the Deccan Plateaus, Malwa Plateaus, and somewhere in the northern part also we will see that are the portions of these Gondwana lands. It means Gondwana lands are the piece of Peninsular Plateau which drifted gradually towards the corner. See the features of Peninsular Plateau. So this Peninsular Plateau is raised from the drifting of Gondwana land. So this Peninsular Plateau is divided into basically 2 parts. One is Central Highland, and second one is Deccan Plateau. Now let us see the meaning of peninsula and plateau. Peninsula means a land mass which is covered from 3 sided of water is called as peninsula. Here we have Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean, and Bay of Bengal. So this is Aravalli range. This comes towards the Rajasthan area, and now in between the Central Highland, means in between the Malwa land and Narmada river, there is one more range, that is Vindhyanchal range. Narmada range is Satpura range. Children, all these ranges are very important for filling your map skill. Now, this complete portion is our Deccan Plateau. And this part is the Central Plateau. So, if we want to remember, we need to remember the division starts from the Narmada River. Now, let us see some common features of Deccan Plateau or the Peninsular Plateau. These especially we find a type of soil that is black soil. We find black soil in plateau region, and also we find growing of cotton, means the cultivation of cotton takes place more and more towards the plateau region. And also one more important feature is that here we find what type of rocks. The types of rocks which we find are, because due to the drifting of the Gondwana land, which was the part of volcanic eruption, the rocks will be of igneous rocks. This Deccan Plateau is higher towards the west and then slopes gradually towards the eastern side. And some portion towards the east, northeast area are Garo, Khasi and Jayantia hills, which we can remember in short as GKJ, that is Garo, Khasi and Jayantia. These hills are very popular in the forms of plateau. So this is the feature of plateau. Now let us see towards the coastal region. Towards the coastal region, this is our Eastern Ghat and this is Western Ghat. Most of the river they meet and enter in the Bay of Bengal. All the south rivers, they mostly meet in the Bay of Bengal. They do not enter from the Arabian Sea, means they do not go and reach to Arabian Sea. Why? Because the hills in this Western Ghats are little broader than the hills of Eastern Ghat. So here we find few deltas which is very popular, framed by different river. Here flows the river Mahanadi, Krishna, Kaveri, all are popular. This great Indian desert lies western of the Aravali Hills. And very popular desert is Thar Desert, which is called as India's largest desert. Now some other feature of Indian desert is that it has very low or less rainfall annually, 150 mm. Due to this, it has less vegetation. Streams appear during monsoon only. Streams appears during monsoon. This area is also called as arid area, or the climate remains very dry in this region.
Let us see some common facts about desert. Camel is the ship of the desert. One of the largest salt lake is in Rajasthan, that is Sambar Lake. Oasis also provides the habitat for animals and humans if area is big in desert.
Discuss the last physical feature of India, that is islands. India has two beautiful islands. One is Andaman Nicobar, which lies towards the Eastern Ghat. Another island in Lakshadweep, which lies towards the Western Ghat. The capital of Lakshadweep island is Kavarti, and it is spread across 32 km2. About Andaman and Nicobar, it is believed that this is the land which is elevated mass of submarine mountain. About Lakshadweep, it is very popular for corals. That's why sometimes this land is also called as Coral Island. Now, these two islands have little bit equatorial type of climate and temperature. Why? Because they are very closer to the equatorial zone.
Let us see some more interesting fact about the island Lakshadweep Island. The only bird sanctuary island located in the Lakshadweep in India is Petty Island. There rarely human being stays. Now in front of you is the real piece of coral. This piece is bought from the Lakshadweep Island. Coral is the hard substance formed from the bones of very small sea animals. Or coral is the hard skeleton left behind by marine polyps that often forms a large structure like a reef. Let us do short chapter checkup. First question is, where do we find oases? In plateaus, deserts, or in plains or islands? Second question, which plateau lies between Aravali and Vindhyanchal range? Malwa Plateau, Dakkan Plateau, Chota Nagpur Plateau, or none of these? Third question is, name the island group of India having coral origin. Andaman Nicobar Island, Lakshadweep Island, both A and B, or none of these. Like all other videos, eagerly waiting for your answers in comment. Thank you for watching.